Hey guys, it's Vignesh from CodeAndroid. In this video, we'll see about Dart 3 and its feature. If you want to use Dart along with Flutter, then you need to use Flutter master channel for now. To do that, run Flutter channel master. But I'm using FVM, so I need to switch to master channel using FVM. To do that, we need to run FVM install master. I already installed it, that's why it's showing the version. Now I can make this master version as default version using FVM global master. If you see my Flutter version, it is 3.7 and Dart version is 3.0. In case you are on different Flutter version and you want to try out Dart 3 feature, then we can download the Dart SDK separately. To do that, go to dart.dev and click on Get Dart. Here, click on the download SDK as a zip file. Currently, 3.0 is available in dev channel, so download the dev channel on your system. Mine is Intel Mac, so I need to download macOS x64. I already downloaded this and extracted it here. Now, we need to use this SDK while creating new project. Opening Android Studio and creating a new Flutter project. In this window, selecting generator as Dart and giving the dev channel Dart SDK path. You can see we have created a Dart project where the minimum SDK version is set to 3.0 because the feature which we are going to see is available only on Dart 3 and above. Let's run this code and see once. You can see we are getting the result. Now, we'll see two main features of Dart 3, records and patterns. To demo that, creating a new Dart file called records and adding the main function. Before we start, we need to enable record feature because currently records and patterns are available in experimental. To enable that, open analysisoption.yaml and enable analyzer. Under this, we need to add enable experiment. Inside this, we need to add records flag. We'll see about the pattern as well, so adding both of them. Now, we have updated the configuration that IDE can use this records and pattern feature. But to run this file along with this configuration, you need to right click on this run and click on modify run configuration. Here, we need to add the experimental flag. Another way is to run the code once to create the run configuration automatically and editing the configuration from here. We need to run this code along with record feature, so adding enable experiment records under VM option. This record feature is mainly used to couple multiple data type. For example, when we want to return more than one data type value from a function. Let's see this from an example. Consider you have a class which handles the data where you have a list which is private. Now you need to do a filter from this list. So we can write a function which does this filter logic and returning the result. Let's call this function from main to do that making this function as static. Also printing the result. Sorry, the flag is misspelled, so I'm correcting it. You can see we are getting the result as apple and pineapple. I want to display the information to the user that how many of the record filtered from the total. To get that, we usually write another function, then we will use the function. But what if we can return the list length along with the filtered list? To do that, simply we can return list of string and integer inside parentheses. While returning also, we need to return list and the list length inside parentheses. Like usual function, records also will do the validation of data type. In our case, first variable is a list of string and second variable is integer. Now we can access the result using $ along with the index. Result of 0 will give the list of string which is filtered, and instead of getting the length using another function, we can use result of $1. Like this, we can combine more than one data type values using records. Now we'll see about patterns. To demo the patterns, I'm duplicating the file and naming it as patterns. Records is allowed to merge multiple data types into single, and patterns allowed to decouple those coupled data. We are getting records from this function, and we want to store this into separate variables, then we can use pattern. This will store the filtered list into result and length into total variable. Let's run the code. Sorry, I need to enable the experimental feature for this file as well. So, editing the configuration for patterns. Here, we need to enable both records and patterns like this. You can see we are getting the same result. We can do more with this pattern. Consider we are getting a JSON string. From this, we need to separate username and user ID. Usually, we decode this using JSON decode, then store it into a variable by typecasting. You can see this is working fine, but these typecasting can fail because we are not checking the variable type and then casting it. Instead of this, we can use pattern to validate, then we can use those variable like this. This will validate the JSON along with its data type, as well as store the values into appropriate variable. If I run this code, we are getting the result twice. One is printed by usual way and another one is printed by pattern. Consider a scenario where user ID is coming as string. At that time, usual way of coding will fail because of typecasting. To check how pattern is working, adding an else case so that we can get to know about failure handling. You can see it's going to the else statement. Because pattern is validated here, in this case user ID is not an integer, so the check is failed. To handle this case, I'm duplicating this pattern and handling string of user ID. You can see we are skipping the first pattern and satisfying the next because of user ID data type. We can do the same using switch case like this. Also, pattern matching allows us to use switch in many more places. For example, consider we have a score variable. If the score is greater than 95, then we want to print grade is A+. To do this, usually we will write the case separately like this. But using pattern, we can replace this using condition. Also, now we can introduce boolean operator inside the case. You can see we are getting A+. After changing the score as 94, we are getting grade A. On setting the score as 90, we are getting no match found. Also, they have added when support in switch case, where we can use different variable inside the case. For example, I'm using when and checking the same variable. This looks stupid, but I just want to show you guys we can use variable inside when. Both cases are satisfied when the score is greater than or equals to 90, but the first case will be satisfied only when the score is greater than 95. You can see we are getting the result as grade A. On changing the score to 96, we are getting the result as grade A+. Note here I'm not adding the break because now break statement is not required. Like this, we can use records and patterns. Now, we'll see how to run this same code on Visual Studio. First, we'll try to run records.dart. We are getting this error because VS Code is using system level dart. My system level dart is 2.9 to check that I'm running Flutter --version. Now, we need to configure VS Code to use custom dart SDK for this project. First, I'm creating launch.json using run and debug menu. In the same folder, creating a file called settings.json. Inside this file, giving our custom .sdk path as ..sdk path. Now, if I try to run this file, the first error is cleared. Still, we are getting this error because of experimental feature flag. To enable that, opening launch.json, inside adding the flag for records and pattern in VM additional args. Also, adding the program as the file path. Let's run the file. You can see we are getting the result. To run patterns, I'm duplicating the configuration and linking patterns.dart. You can see we are getting the result for patterns. Like this, we can try out .3 feature without disturbing our Flutter configuration. That's all for this video, guys. If you have any doubt, please put it in the comment section. I will try to answer it. Hope you like it. I will see you in my next video. Have a nice day.